Thanks everyone for joining us and those who are joining us. We have Archana with us. She will be talking about outcome-driven teams. And this is Priyanka. Thank you for joining us today. All yours, Archana.
Thank you, Priyanka. And good afternoon, everybody. And today's session, I'll be talking about why outcome-centricity is important and what is outcome-centric teams, and how you can kickstart this journey with your team. So before we start, a quick introduction about myself. My name is Archana Maliyekal. I am an Agile coach who works for Sixt, which is a global mobility provider in Germany. So I'm settled in Munich. I started my career as a software developer a long time back in 2006. And right now I am into coaching teams and organizations, almost 8 years into it. And I thoroughly enjoy that journey now. The core values which I follow in my personal as well as professional life is I'm really curious person, love to learn new things, experiment, and leave things better than how I find it. So let's start this session with a small reflection from your side about this whole topic. So imagine you are going back to your team tomorrow or Monday and asking these questions. Who is your customer? And what customer value did you produce in last 6 months? Take a moment to reflect on this, what your team's would be answering. So these were exactly the same questions which I asked my team almost 8 months back. And the answers which I got, it really left me speechless or perplexed. Because for the first question, who is your customer? Most of the teams, they were answering or asking me the question, so Archana, whom should we consider as our customer? Is it an internal customer or an external customer? So this made me reflect the fact that many times teams does not have a shared understanding about who their customer is. And for the second question, it was even more interesting because teams were answering with, okay, we delivered this feature, we rolled out this project, we build this API. These were the customer values which teams were talking about. So I'm pretty sure maybe many of you can relate to this. So why should you know who your customer is? Of course, you should know who you are serving for, but most importantly, if you don't know who your customer is, how are you going to solve their problems? How are you going to serve them? An employment engagement survey, which happened recently, came up with this particular fact that employees who know their customer, who knows their purpose, are better engaged in their work compared to the peers. Now, I think this is something which we all can relate to. And let me tell you another story about this. So President Mr. John F. Kennedy, once in 1962, he was visiting NASA and he was doing a tour, and he saw this guy standing there mopping the floor, and he just went near him and asked this question, "What's your job?" For which he gave an answer, "Mr. President, I am helping to put a man on the moon." Now you imagine your organization, your team, know their purpose, know their customers, and working in a bi-directional manner to achieve that. That's the dream. Remember, when you take a roadmap to your team, you're just asking them to build some features and giving them some timelines. However, if you're asking your teams to think about outcomes, you're actually giving them autonomy, there you're making them responsible and own their deliverables. So now that I spoke about outcome, and what is this outcome I'm talking about? So outcome is a change in human behavior that drives business results. So this particular statement is by Joshua Seiden, who has wrote this book, Outcomes Over Output. If you have not read it, I would highly recommend reading this book. That's the eye-opener. So in this, if you see, outcomes are measurable. Outcomes are observable because it is linked to human. And this human could be anybody. It could be your external customer. It could be an internal user, an internal employee, whomsoever is in your context. Now, the question comes, how can you link your day-to-day work to these outcomes? So, this is a very beautiful drawing done by Jeff Patton, who is the author of User Story Mapping. So whatever task your projects, your user stories, your epics, features, Jiras, Excel sheets, all these are your outputs. So outputs generate outcome. And the important part here is when used by the customers. So there is a human interaction which is happening and which generates your impact. And what is your impact? Your company revenue, increase your users' base, extend it to some other countries, the business, et cetera, et cetera. So you cannot jump directly from output to your impact without this outcome. And whatever outputs which are not used will not create an impact, which is why thinking about outcomes and customers are really, really, really important. Now, if you're thinking, how can you kickstart this journey? First step is to bring the awareness. So I remember in one of the previous talks in today's conference by Ashish and Sujata, who were talking about the OKR, they were stressing the importance of outcomes and, you know, bringing the awareness. Exactly the same thing I would like to bring up here. Start with awareness. So in my organization, when we started this, people didn't know what was outcomes and what was impact. Many times, especially when you talk to leaders, they will mistake outcomes for impacts. They will talk about product deliverables, migration, etc. So we did workshops about output, outcome, impact, asking teams who your customer is and how, what value they are producing. And what we observed was, after a few months, people started thinking about outcomes. They know what is outcome. It's not that they can influence it, but they know what is outcome. They can distinguish it. That is the first step to this whole journey. Now, what can you do next? So for this, I would like to give you the story of ShopNot. So ShopNot is an imaginary organization or imaginary company which owns an app which sells clothes online. They have only clothes and they have around 2,000 employees. So they launched a new feature called pre-owned, where customers can actually resell their used clothes, which is good because nowadays, you know, clothes are lying in the wardrobe, so they want to get rid of it. That's a good cause for the community. So CEO, Mr. Jack, he came up with a very ambitious plan to increase the revenue from the pre-owned feature to 0.5 million. And he communicated it to all his divisions, departments. So one product manager, Steffi, she was thinking, how can I take this impact? So if you see, this is a revenue, this is an impact. how can I take this impact to my team and how can I influence it? So she was interacting with two teams. So let's say one team is marketing team and one team is an app team. What did she do in order to for the teams to come up with outcomes to realize this impact? She asked a few questions to the team. The question, first question was, what are the customer behaviors that drive business results? So if you see this question, the focus is not on the features, but rather on the customer behavior. And many times you have data to support and come up with answers for this. Many times you might not have data. And asking this question can even make teams to think about, so what is the customer doing now? How is he or she interacting with the application? Is there a different way they can do it? And discussions around this. So this is the first golden question which you can ask your team, or even we have asked our team. Now, when Steffi asked this question to the team, she didn't have any data to support. So what she did was, she did a hypothesis. So hypothesis is something, a belief, that if we do this, this can happen. So in her team, so the app team and the marketing team, so the app team thought that, okay, we believe that if the customer notices this button, because right now this button is not visible at all, and just in the UI, if that is more prominent, then people will go and use that. And marketing team, probably they thought, okay, the whatever is happening right now, customers are not aware, let's launch and enhance our campaign. And I can give another example here. So in my organization, there is this app, as I said, it's a global mobility provider. There is this app where people can come and book cars. So this was based on a data analysis where we found that customers who are booking this car, actually, I think one step before ending the process, they're just not continuing. So the team did brainstorming and think coming up with ideas. And one thing which team thought was, okay, let's do a notification to the user just one day after, asking them, hey, you have left this booking, would you like to rebook? And what we ran this experiment, I think, for almost 2 months and with some specific user groups. And what we found that around 70% of the customers came back and continued their booking. So now if you see the customers who forget about it or got distracted in their mobile, they could continue with their booking. And from a company perspective, the number of bookings have increased. So this is just a small example. So this is the way you have to think about the team. Now, the second question, how can we get people to do more of those behaviors? So you can think of, now you talk about the features. So this will also lead to an interesting fashion where people think about the goal of people changing their behavior. So sometimes it could be small UI changes. Sometimes it could be social media promotions or advertisements. It need not be your real feature. So these kind of possibilities can open up. So for Steffi, when she asked her team, what was happened was some customers may click on pre-owned feature if we enhance the button. So they decided to enhance the button with a different color. And for the marketing team, they decided to launch a campaign called Clutter-Free Boto. So when these are kind of ideas, which is like minimal effort, but still you can change the customer behaviors. And the third question is, how do we know you're right? So when you run experiments, you measure it and then learn it. This is the cycle there. You just build and just leave the feature, then you don't know what happened with that. Many times in teams, that's what we are doing. We release the features to production, and then you don't know what happened with that. Which is why exactly the experiment or A-B testing. So those of you who don't know A-B testing, it is alternate testing or split testing, you would say, where some set of features are being tested with one set of users, another test with another set of users. So these are only some ways. There are different ways to do this. However, the important thing is focus on metrics which teams can influence. So if you think about metrics like revenue, those are all impact. It takes a time. However, your product team can still figure out the metrics of the product. Like, for example, in our example with Steffi and her team, the marketing team thought of measuring the share rate, which is something they can measure by the team themselves. App team decided to, okay, the number of times the users click the button, we know that maybe they will lead to more bookings. So which is why it is always important to focus on leading indicators or metrics which the teams can immediately or very soon measure. And if you see here, so these are some of the examples of the leading click rate, share rate, users per transaction. And let's take an example of Netflix. What can you measure? The number of the view time of by the users. These things the teams can measure by themselves. They don't, or maybe two teams can collaboratively measure, but you don't need input from 10 teams to answer this. So the product outcomes or the outcomes leads to impact your revenue, customer retention, reduce cost, et cetera, et cetera. So some tips from where we have started this journey. Step one, bring awareness to your team for them to become outcome-centric. Start with a project where you can experiment. So if one team cannot influence the outcome, combine it. So in this case, if you see the marketing team and the app team, they combinedly created the outcome. And even if it is internal customer, it is fine. So I remember doing this workshop with the HR team and asking this question about, they had this problem to increase employee engagement. Now, how can you increase employee engagement? That leads to very wonderful discussion. And data and experiments are your friend. So these are like your core, and maybe if the teams don't have access immediately, you have to kickstart this journey. So like any other journey, like agile transformations or mindset or scaling, outcome centricity is also a journey which takes time depending on your organizational context and people. And what is most important is to aim for progress than perfection. So kickstart this journey with your teams tomorrow. Ask this question, who is your customer and what customer value you're producing? So with this, I think I'm already on time here. I would like to conclude my short session. Thanks for joining me. And if you have any questions, or if you'd like to discuss about this topic, please feel free to reach out to me. Thank you. Bye-bye.